Hello, sports fans. Steven Wolf here, and got to my new place. That's why the difference of scenery this time. Well, new place, new area, bigger, bigger, bigger. It's bigger now, in a way. So if you're wondering why to change the scenery, that's why. For the NHL playoffs, I wanted to do a bracket, but during the time when during the past few weeks, I had to move to a new place and had to get everything cleaned up, so I won't be doing that. For NBA, I will do that, but yeah. With this one, if I remember correctly, for Eastern Conference, I know the Capitals, the Penguins. For Western Conference, the Wild are back to the playoffs. Everyone's pretty much new, more or less. But Yuri Gurin is going to have something to say each and every one of them. What's he going to say about Pittsburgh this time? Does he think they have a chance, or they're going to be bottom feeders? And will they face the Capitals again? Oh, I can't wait to see what he says about Capitals this time. Well, here goes nothing. Enjoy. And in 3, 2, 1, play.
April is such a beautiful month. Playoff
That's
hockey
right.
is upon us. One of the more grueling 2 month spans in all of sports. A test of physical and mental will in order to race that immaculate cup of Lord Stanley. Hopefully we don't get a shitload of overtime games this year. Who are the 16 contestants entering the arena? The once hunted has now become the league's hunter. What could be argued as one of the hottest teams in the NHL is looking to return to the final with a much different result. The center depth
Will
is stacked. The
Preds
defense is back in full strength. And
like
Red
Wings versus Pittsburgh.
Well, status quo for him. The Catfish are being slaughtered without mercy. You have expectations placed upon your shoulders for once. Don't end up like your fallen President's Trophy winning brothers before you. Keep Rene away from his trip tonight. PPG Paints Arena.
Ooh.
Years of waiting in the shadows, years of hoping for something, anything out of this franchise has paid off. The youth has emerged into a mismatch of skill
now,
and precision. Connor Hellebuck has been the goaltender the Jets have desperately needed. They even got a surprise addition in Paul Stastny. Even though their playoff experience rests between barren desert and gaping chasm, the Winnipeg
Ooh.
Faithful deserve something good for their loyalty. Win a playoff game. Hell, win a series. Cleanse that horrible Atlanta stench off of you. Minnesota,
Always
here's
be
the situation.
With you.
You're not expected to do a damn thing as you're running into a steamroller known as the Jets. Consistency is a major issue this year. The Wild are still a team that is in the limbo of second-tier futility and may be leaning at the edge of a precipice. Your head coach is the infamous Tex-Mex connoisseur,
Ooh,
Bruce Boudreau.
That
Think
guy.
It gets easier, silly kid. You're a team in Minnesota. Your defensive keystone, Ryan Suter, he's not going to be joining your
Ouch.
Party. The Geiger readings of panic are off the charts. It's going to take a miracle for you to go anywhere. What's Sister Jean up to? I don't get it. A team I expect to be a playoff contender the year before is cursed by an enemy spell and spits out one of the worst seasons in NHL history. The team proceeds to do next to nothing in the offseason, and the curse is lifted as the team returns to being a playoff contender. What the fuck happened here? If I can guess,
you being
Nathan
wrong.
MacKinnon. Ever since Duchesne was traded, the Avs have taken off and he has been the main benefactor. They've got the pieces to make an impact in the future, but it's looking to be an ass-kicking this year. Losing your best goalie and defenseman to injury will do that. With how awful last year was, I take this and run for the hills. The neophyte of the NHL exceeding all expectations and winning the Pacific Division with a blend of skill and likability. Just
Vegas,
like we
baby.
All predicted in Bizarro
Vegas.
World. Now we see if analytics and the moves made by George McPhee will lead to success in the playoff realm. The good news for the rest of us is that Marc-Andre Fleury has had an unfortunate string of concussions, leaving goaltending in question for the time being. I would admit, it would be a pretty epic troll job for the clock to strike midnight on this Cinderella story. I think I'm getting sick from all of this shit eating. My stomach needs a break. The Ducks got healthy again and are scorching the league like a California wildfire. With Getzlaff back to doing his usual stick, Anaheim boasts some of the best center depth in the West. They're looking for revenge after being victimized by the horrors of Bernier last postseason.
Ooh.
Maybe they'll end up like the city's traffic situation and nobody will show up until halfway through the second period. It would be the most fitting punishment this side of how cheap and dirty this fucking team is. Well, the Sharks have usurped the horrors of mediocrity and have gone on a furious tear throughout the West Coast. Where the hell have I heard this story before? Oh, right, nearly every year for
rinse
the past decade
repeat.
And a half.
This team
this
is rinse and repeat.
This deadline acquisition is Evander Kane, whom has
Can
managed
get over
to keep his
hump?
Head down and grind away for the most productive stretch of his career. This is your first chance at a cup post Marlowe. You'll need all hands on deck to have a chance at the final again. Although when you falter this year, it's not a matter of if, it's when. I have something special planned for you.
Oh.
I await how you'll break my heart this year.
I
when
can't
the
wait
West
for that
Coast
video.
Club was installed as the new Masters last summer, little did we all know that the majority
Knight
of the team
LA
would turn
Kings.
Back the clock 5 years.
We'll be
well,
checkmate
when they
for
of
the
a
Kings.
One may think to dismiss them because
by
they're
Vegas.
Old, inconsistent, and their depth is embarrassing, but they've been down this road before. They know the traps. Jonathan Quick turns into a brick wall again, and the Kings pull another deep playoff run out of their ass. Maybe add in a reverse sweep for good measure. All we can hope for is that I'm wrong, and the main course of the night is regicide. Remember that Tampa Bay boner I had
Bam!
Back at the deadline? It's gone flaccid. The whole team has chosen to sputter and spiral into a flaming fury. Such stupidity, rampant stagnation. Vasilevsky
and got
has developed
number
massive
one
holes
East,
in his game for
East
reasons
spot because of the Panthers.
That one straight tiger of January has morphed into a purring kitten. You guys are soft. Like, I could hit this team with a feather and they would fall over in paralysis.
Hey.
Get your fucking shit together, Lightning. Chris Kunitz needs to win his fifth cup somewhere, and it may as well be with you guys. Boston is once again blessed with another great sports team with championship ambitions. Are we sure that the sports gods aren't rigging this entire goddamn operation? Every time I look at the squad, I get flashbacks to the 2016 Penguins, the emphasis on youth and speed, the revitalization of the old guard, the near unstoppable
what team are you looking at again?
That has been crushing everything and everyone in its path. This team can make noise this postseason. I only hope it's the noise of somebody breaking Brad Marchand's legs. You hear it, everyone? Listen closely. It's the sound of Maple Leafs fans stampeding in the distance, boasting about how their team is going to win the cup this season. No legitimate counterpoints about how the Bruins may crush their spirits again or how Frederik Andersen is the epitome of inconsistency will be tolerated. They've waited oh so long for another chance at Lord Stanley. Shrines to their golden god Austin Matthews are being constructed as I speak. These will most likely be chucked into the incinerator like Foster Hewitt's gondola in a few weeks. We know we are in an ultimate
Boo.
Timeline when the New Jersey Devils aren't a team that puts everyone to sleep. This iteration is full of speed and youth and action and excitement. Taylor Hall is LeBron's god that Newark has been begging for since days of Rodeur. In fact, Keith Kincaid must have killed Marty in his sleep and usurped all of his talent. Everyone is going to dismiss them because they're young and inexperienced, but these are the teams that pour hot oil on you when you're wrong. I learned my lesson from Vegas. The regular
really?
Season has meant nothing to the Capitals for so long that it's hard to gauge any kind of excitement for the team. This year's rendition is weaker than the all-in squad that choked away a series to a vastly inferior group last season, but it still has its bright points. Philipp Grubauer is the German god in net that has been missing since Ole the goalie. The high-end talent is once again leading the charge. Unfortunately for you, you're dealing with terrible defense depth and a coach that thinks it's a good idea to give human anchor Brooks Orpik a permanent defensive shift. Can you guys at least make it to the third round this year? Even I'm getting tired of this narrative. The quest for a three-peat has upped the difficulty to European extreme. The first year was
three
a mere breeze, even though the back end was sketchy.
Three-peat.
Last year was pants-shitting success despite massive holes in defense. Now the Pens get to try it with an even shittier defense. This time
wow.
It's being led by Hockey's Valley Girl
wow.
Chris Letang, coughing up the puck like he has tuberculosis. Matt Murray has also lost his swagger and has dealt with unfortunate circumstances off of the ice.
At I don't think
rate,
I've seen someone native to his own, state that basically, wow,
this team
basically just
what I see is untapped
like
potential.
Pour
look at all
oil,
of the
oil
talent
and fire on his own
system.
Team.
They waste it. Even if they have some of the worst goaltending in the playoffs, the real issue the Flyers face is the guy behind the bench. Anything to satiate those precious veterans that are hogging up a roster spot. Allow me to give you some advice. Unleash the youth. It will make things so much easier. They're either getting blown out early or going deep. There is no middle ground. After they lose, Radko Gudas should fulfill his life's ambition and become a lumberjack.
Oh.
You made the playoffs again. I would normally congratulate you, but it's now time for you to do something besides show up to the dance. The Jackets have a sexy gloss with Artemi Panarin and Pierre-Luc Dubois flashing skill on unsuspecting onlookers. This is probably the deepest team Columbus has ever had, even if they lack a franchise center. Win more than two games this year. The last thing Ohio needs is more misery from its sports team. As long as someone chucks Tortorella into a volcano to generate a series win, I'm fine with whatever they do. What, you want a prediction again? Did you see how disastrous last year's one went? Fuck it, you want a prediction? Washington versus San Jose. The two legacies of failure against one another in a fight to the death. And then they somehow both lose just because. I'm going to have to do another Hater's Guide to the Hater's Guide, aren't I?
One desperate shot there. Another one from Subban deflected wide. And they're on the ice to celebrate. The Pittsburgh Penguins have done it again. Back-to-back Stanley Cup victories.
Wow. Wow. So yeah, that was Yuri and Tree's Guide to the Playoffs. Wow. This is I gotta say, that's pretty. Okay. From what I can see, the Stanley Cup playoffs will have Nashville versus Colorado, Winnipeg versus Minnesota, Vegas versus Kings, Anaheim versus San Jose, Tampa Bay versus the Devils, Boston versus Toronto, Washington versus Columbus, Pittsburgh versus Philly. Yeah, those are your teams for the Stanley Cup. This is going to be a quick bracket prediction. I think Nashville will take Colorado. I won't say how many games because you can never really predict how many really games. Winnipeg versus Minnesota. I say Winnipeg has the chance. Just because. for Vegas versus Kings, if they had Marc-Andre Fleury still, I would say Vegas, but LA Kings have Jonathan Quick. Again, this is me just running through all the teams. But Vegas proved they can do, even when they had their emergency backup, they can do well on their own. I say Vegas. But then again, they're not that inexperienced because they pretty much had everyone from each and every team. The Ducks versus San Jose. I say San Jose. That's my wild card for that one. I need to at least pick one upset. For the Eastern Conference, I say Lightning. Boston versus Toronto. Oh, Boston. Columbus versus Washington. Columbus. Well, Washington. Pittsburgh versus Philly. I say Pittsburgh. So we're gonna have another Washington versus Pittsburgh matchup. Maybe I'm a little too biased, but this is me running through this. I didn't have no history, no nothing, any of that stuff. I've been nursing a migraine because of this, so I'm running through this really quickly. Nashville versus Winnipeg. I say Nashville for this one. Vegas versus San Jose. I say San Jose. I'm sorry, Kings. I mean, Knights. Sorry. Grogulant may have, learned from experience of the previous pass, but I don't think he will get past the second round. It's still a learning curve for him. Tampa versus Boston. Considering Boston has been having trouble lately, I say Lightning will win out the series. And as for Capitals versus Pittsburgh, if history serves, Pittsburgh will win this. So it's Lightning versus Pens, San Jose versus Nashville. I say Nashville will win this series and return to Stanley Cup greatness. For Lightning versus Pittsburgh, I say Lightning get this one. If what Yuri and Tree says about their defense, I think Lightning got this in the bag. So it's Lightning versus Nashville. two number ones. This, again, this is just me predicting whatever. if I had more time, I would probably do an in-depth review of each and every team, what their chances are. Well, this is just me, like, briefing through this. I'm pretty sure everyone has a different challenge, different picks than me. As for Nashville versus Lightning, Music City gets the series. I'm sorry. I should be picking Florida, but I don't think they have it in them. I really should pay attention more to the games, more or less. yeah, that's my pick for the Stanley Cup playoff. Nashville will win the cup. If I'm wrong, well, again, I didn't do much research, and this is me briefing skimming. Again, I've been doing so many things I didn't have time to really do my research. I just wanted to put up this reaction video and everything. Yeah, honestly, in the video, Vegas, congratulations, they did their best. I mean, they got to the playoffs because of basically picking good players, good picks, and having a good coach. Why the heck Florida got rid of them will forever haunt Florida, one of the mistakes of the hockey franchise. If he were to win the cup, it'll be a slap to the face. Like Philly, when Philadelphia Eagles got Jay Ajayi from the Dolphins, yeah, you can feel the burns coming from the guy. Oh, wow. So yeah. Basically, Philly and New Jersey got in by the skin of their teeth. Well, not skin of their teeth, but if things would have gone for the Panthers way, they would have easily gone in. Maybe face the Lightning. I wanted the Lightning to face the Panthers. It was like one of those rare and one of a lifetime opportunities you get to see. And from what I can tell, I could be wrong about Boston versus Toronto, because someone said Boston were to give up the first goal in each of the past few games. If they do that, if they allow Toronto to get ahead of them, that Boston will be in trouble early in this playoff race, in this tournament. What I'm trying to say is, Toronto will easily take that advantage and run with it. So yeah, that's my reaction. Same next time, I hope to put up the Heat video for their playoff preview. Thanks for watching. Bye.